दिस इज़ डॉक्टर विजयलक्ष्मी नायडू, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर बॉटनी, गवर्नमेंट VYT PG, ऑटोनोमस कॉलेज दुर्ग, विद अ टॉपिक टू स्टडी एनवायरमेंटल इम्पैक्ट ऑफ अ गिवन डेवलपमेंटल एक्टिविटी यूजिंग चेक लिस्ट एज एन EIA मैथड. इट इज़ द पार्ट ऑफ सिलेबस ऑफ MSc फोर्थ सेमेस्टर बॉटनी प्रैक्टिकल लैब कोर्स 1. EIA means Environmental Impact Assessment, and it is an important management tool for ensuring optimal use of natural resources for sustainable development. And EIA has many steps like screening. What is a screening? Screening is done to determine whether or not a proposal should be subject to EIA, and if so, at what level of detail. Second, scoping. Scoping seeks to identify at an early stage from all of a project's possible impacts and from all the alternatives that could be addressed, those that are the crucial significant issues. Third, the consideration of alternatives. It seeks to ensure that the proponent has considered other feasible approaches, including alternative project locations, scales, processes, layouts, operating conditions, and the no action option. Then, description of the project action includes a clarification of the purpose and rationale of the project and an understanding of its various characteristics, including stages of development, location, and processes. Then comes description of the environmental baseline, includes the establishment of both the present and future state of the environment in the absence of the project, taking into account changes resulting from natural events and from other human activities. Then comes the identification of the main impacts. It brings together the previous steps with the aim of ensuring that all potentially significant environmental impacts are identified and taken into account in the process. Next is prediction of impacts. Aims to identify the magnitude of impact, extent of impact, duration of impact, and significance of the impact of identified change in the environment with a project or action by comparison with the situation without that project or action. Next is evaluation and assessment of significance. It assesses the relative significance of the predicted impacts to allow a focus on the main adverse impacts. Then mitigation, which involves the introduction of measures to avoid, reduce, remedy, or compensate for any significant adverse impacts. And the objectives of mitigation are find better alternatives and ways of doing things, enhance the environmental and social benefits of a project, avoid, minimize, or remedy adverse impacts, and ensure that residual adverse impacts are kept within acceptable levels. In public consultation and participation, the aim to ensure the equality, comprehensiveness, and effectiveness of the EIA and that the public's views are adequately taken into consideration in the decision-making process. Then comes the EIS presentation. EIS presentation is a vital step in the process. If done badly, much good work in the EIA may be negated. The EIS, that is Environmental Impact Statement, or EIA report, provides documentation of the information and estimates derived from the various steps in the EIA process. So that is about the steps involved in EIA. Now, what is the purpose of EIA? It promotes sustainable development by identifying environmentally sound practice and mitigation measures for developments, ensure that environmental consequences were taken into account during planning, designing, and decision-making process to influence how it is subsequently managed during its implementation. Paryavaran Prabhav Aakalan. ये environmental impact assessment का हिंदी अनुवाद है और पिछले कुछ दशकों में पर्यावरण के हानि को ध्यान में रखे बिना कई विकास परियोजनाएं चलाए गए और इसके कारण पर्यावरण काफ़ी मात्रा में प्रदूषित हो गया और इन हानियों को ध्यान में रखते हुए सरकार और आम जनता विकास के परियोजनाओं के प्रभाव को लेकर चिंतित है। जब साल 1978 में कुछ नदी घाटी से संबंधित परियोजना पर काम चालू होने वाला था तब EIA का गठन हुआ और यह पर्यावरण संरक्षण एक्ट 1986 के अंतर्गत आता है। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट आर EIA मेथडोलॉजीज। These are based on equality, openness, approaches. The criteria for selection of appropriate method involves simplicity, budget and time, and flexibility. Simplicity. The methodology should be simple and based upon available manpower and background knowledge. It can be adaptable without much difficulty. Budget and time. The methodology should be applied by small group within approved budget. Flexibility. The method should be flexible and allow the modifications and changes during course of study. Methodology requirements. The best methods should be able to organize a large mass of heterogeneous data, allow summarization of data, aggregate the data into smaller sets with less of information, display the raw data and the derived information in a direct and relevant fashion. Target audience should also be considered. Now we are seeing here the checklist method, and the types of checklists are as follows: simple checklist, descriptive checklist, scaling checklist, scaling weighting checklists, and questionnaire checklist. First, we are going to see the simple checklist. Simple checklist is a simple list of environmental parameters and no information needed regarding the magnitude or importance of impacts. Checklist can recognize resource or environmental component which are affected due to particular activities. The examples given in the table for construction sites, the tick mark confirm that impact is there. No tick mark or leaving the box blank means there is no impact. Simple checklist can also give idea about type of impacts like short-term impact, long-term, reversible or irreversible. In this table, we are going to see the simple checklist can also give idea about type of impacts. As we studied earlier, the impacts can be short-term, long-term, reversible or irreversible. And as we studied earlier, that if a tick mark is put in the box, it means impact is there. And if the box is left without putting the tick mark, it means there is no impact. Example is taken here. Like in the first column, we can see that is about the air quality, then water quality. So if any kind of impact is there in that particular column, the tick mark is there, and if no, then it is left blank. Descriptive checklist. An example of a descriptive checklist is presented here, which includes past, present and future actions. The checklist can also discuss the cumulative impacts due to past activities, project and other nearby sources. That is also given in the table, and with this table we can understand what is a descriptive checklist. Scaling checklist. For example, for the rating of water quality, that is if it is best, 5 and 1 for worst. A representative example is given below for scaling of parameters. Like for low, it is mentioned 1, medium 2, high 3, like that. So with this table we can understand what is a scaling checklist. Then comes the fourth type of checklist, that is scaling weighting checklist. Weighting means giving importance to specific parameters. For example, water quality may be of prime importance in one project as compared to land area. Hence, here along with scaling, weightage is given to water parameter so that it becomes more important in evaluation. Scaling weighting checklist represent scaling checklists with information. The structured equations are used to weigh the environmental parameters. Scaling weighting checklist. Other points are, the scaling weighting checklist involves primarily two methods. The first is environment evaluation value system, and second is Battelli environment evaluation. The first we are going to see here, that is environment evaluation value system. The environmental evaluation system, that is EES, is a methodology which conducts environmental impact analysis. The EES evaluates environmental impact in four major categories, such as ecology, environmental pollution, aesthetics, and human interest. Major features of the EES are its hierarchical classification system, its commensurate unit of measure, recognition of environmentally sensitive areas. The second is Bettelli environment evaluation. The Bettelli environmental evaluation system, that is EES, is a methodology developed by Bettelli Columbus Laboratories for conducting environmental impact analysis. It is based on a hierarchical assessment of environmental quality indicators. The system is based on classification consisting of four levels, which are further subdivided. Level 1, categories. Level 2, components. Level 3, parameters. And level 4 has measurements. Bettelli environment evaluation. The scores are produced with and without project activities. The system is based on classification consisting of four levels, which are further subdivided. For example, at a scale of 10, the score is 8 before starting a project and it became 3 after completion of project. Then measurement of impact is 5, which means high impact, and if difference is 2, it means less impact. Bettelli environment system, that is EES, table shows the complete list of categories, components and parameters of the Bettelli EES. Column 1 shows the 4 categories, column 2 shows the 18 components and column 3 shows the 78 parameters. The EES methodology depends upon the assignment of an importance unit to each parameter, and collectively these importance units are referred to as parameters importance units, that is PIU. A total of 1000 PIUs is distributed among the 78 parameters based on value judgments. The individual PIUs are shown in column 4 of table 6. The summation component PIUs are shown in column 5, and the summation category PIUs are shown in column 6. Questionnaire checklists. The checklist is prepared on the basis of questionnaire for public consultation as given in the table. It gives information about the stakeholders' awareness and responses for their proposed project. The questionnaire is further evaluated in spreadsheets to find the scale of impacts and weight of parameters based on public opinion. Advantages of checklist method. It is simple to understand and use, good for the selection and priority setting, and impacts can see on past, present and future. It has some disadvantages also, like do not distinguish between direct and indirect impacts, do not link action and impact. Sometimes it is a cumbersome task. Thank you.